SchoolFreeware's free Pascal program tutorials. Tutorial 5, if statements. These are the relational operators that if statements use. The syntax for the if statement is as follows. We have if followed by the condition, then we'll begin, we'll have the computer do something, and then we'll end the if statement. If the condition is not met, then this code right here will not be run. If statements may also contain else-if conditions. There may be multiple else-if conditions or none at all within the statement. Also, if statements may contain an else condition. The code used within this tutorial can be downloaded at schoolfreeware.com. I have made a new project program. I've already added the code to make the computer stop. I'll start off with a simple if statement. If 5 is greater than 2, then I'll begin and write line to the screen telling the user that 5 is greater than 2. Okay, the computer already puts in an end with a semicolon there for me. I'm going to go ahead and run. And the computer responds correctly that 5 is greater than 2. If I were to try the if statement, if 2 is greater than 5, then I'll begin. I'll write line, telling the user that 2 is greater than 5. Okay, so we'll go ahead and run. And I don't see 2 is greater than 5 because this condition here would never be met. And the messages within Lazarus are telling me that this code is unreachable because of the mathematical situation within the condition. Next, I'll have the user enter in two integers, and we'll have the computer check to see which integer is greater than the other. So I'm going to go up here to the area underneath uses. I'm going to put in var, and I'm going to need two integers. I'll have num1 as an integer, and num2 will also be an integer. I'm going to right line a few spaces to the screen, and I'll write, prompting the user to enter first integer. I'll then reline the input into num1. Then I'm going to write to the screen, prompting the user to enter second integer. Then line the user's input into num2. I'll then write line a space to the screen and start my if statement. If num1 is greater than num2, then I'm going to begin and write line to the screen the first integer is greater. Now the computer put an end semicolon here, and I have to remove the semicolon because I don't want the if statement to end right here. I just want this section of the code to end and not the whole if statement. So I'm going to remove that semicolon and then put the else if condition. So else if num2 is greater than num1, then we'll begin and write line to the screen the second integer is greater. Now there's a possibility that both numbers are exactly the same, in which case I'll have to remove this semicolon here, and I'll put in an else. I'll begin, write line to the screen telling the user the integers are the same. And the computer ends with a end semicolon, and that's what we need here, is to remember to use the semicolon at the very end of the if statement. So the if statement actually ends right here. So I'll go ahead and run, and we'll test this out. Okay, enter first integer, 4. The second one will be 5. So the second integer is greater. All right. I'll go test out another possibility. 5 and 4. The first one is greater. Yes, that works. All right. And we'll try for the third possibility that the integers are the same. 5 and 5. The integers are the same.